If you have already subscribed, then click the bell icon to get instant notifications when I put a new video up. Do it now. What's up guys, I am Rob and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, thank you so much for stopping by, but I suggest you click on that subscribe button and be part of the family because we do a lot of cool stuff here. And today I am doing a DIY project which is super simple. I'm making a world map wall clock, that too with some recycled material. So if you like recycling or you like traveling, I'm very sure you like this one. So get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. All right, let's get started. So like I said, I am making a wall clock, and for that I'm using this paint can lid, recycling a paint can lid. It's very sturdy, very strong. I picked it up from an old paint can, and this will be the base of our wall clock. So let's get started, shall we? So like I said, this is the base of our wall clock. Now what we are going to do is we are going to make a hole for our wall clock mechanism to fit in this. Now to make a hole, I am using this thumb pin. Now this paint can is pretty strong, pretty thick. So you'll have to apply a little bit of pressure. Now I'll just move it around in that hole. Just a little wiggle wiggle. Basically we need to make the hole slightly bigger. Now that I have a hole, I'm going to use scissors to make the hole bigger. So apply a little bit of pressure, keep pushing the scissors through the lid and keep rotating, and you'll get a nice big hole in the lid. And keep checking in the middle. See, right now it's still small. It's not passing through. So we need to make it bigger. Okay, this looks big enough. So let's try. There you go. And now you can put a lock. So you get a lot of pieces like this with your mechanism. So you can take out the lock and you can just lock it. So we have our mechanism and we have our base. Now this looks very plain. Obviously it looks like a paint can lid. So we have to make this look impressive. And like I said earlier, we are making a world map wall clock. So for that, I am going to take a cork sheet and make a world map on that. So here I have a cork sheet and you can see the size is pretty similar to our paint can lid. Now I have to cut a circular shape out of that, which will fit inside this lid. So let's take the measurements. I'm using a compass because I want to cut a circular shape. So we'll take from the center out right here. So this is the radius of the circle, like that. Now using this measurement, I am going to take a marking on this cork sheet. So there you go. We have a marking. Now you have to cut this cleanly. So let's do that. There you go. We have a perfect circle here. Let's see. Yeah, fits nicely. Right now I have the mechanism, so we can take that out. There you go, quite a snug fit, looks nice. But I don't want this basic look. I want to make it look a little more impressive and also have the world map on this. So I want to take it out and I'll show you how you can add some more details on this. So first I am going to paint the cork sheet black. So I'll use some acrylic colors and paint it. So let's put in a newspaper because I don't want the paint to get onto the board or the table. Although the cork sheet has a nice color and texture, but I just want a little darker look for my wall clock, and that's why I'm painting it black. Okay, so you can see I have done a coat of black, but I have not done a very flat or dark coat. It's pretty light. You can still see the grains of the cork sheet, and I wanted a texture to show, and you can clearly see the texture is showing. So this is done. I'll keep it aside for drying and we will quickly paint the lid. And to paint this, I am using spray paints. I'm using copper color. Keep a good distance between your surface and the paint can, about 6 to 8 inches, and make sure you do it in a well-ventilated area. Okay, so you can see I have a nice clean coat on this. Now we can keep this aside for drying and bring in the cork sheet to add details to that. Okay, you can see this is ready. It has dried up nicely and it has a nice coat of black. So now that this is dry and ready, let's add details to this. And with a gold pen, I am going to add the world map on this. So when you're drawing, you can look at a reference from the internet or a magazine or book and follow that. Or you can just add your design and shape the world the way you want. Okay, so I'm done with the basic outline. Looks pretty nice, but now I am going to fill in a gold color so that it looks nice and solid. I can use the pen, but it'll take longer, so I'm going to use some gold paint. I'm filling up a nice solid color, but I'm keeping the coat light so that we still have the texture of the cork board. Okay, I am done with the acrylic color. Now I am going to just finish this up using my gold pen again. So here I'm adding another outline so that our shapes stand out a little more. Okay, we are done. And you can see with the outline, it looks even better. And now we can place this in the paint can lid that we have. So let's bring that in. So here's the lid, it's dried up nicely. And if you notice, it has a lot of scratches on it. Right here, you can see, you know, some dents, some marking. And that was the reason why I wanted to add a layer on it and not just paint it flat. So let's do it. There you go. So you can see it fits well. It's looking nice. I'm very happy with this. But you'll also notice that because of the water, because we painted this, there's a slight bulge. So I think it'll be better if I stick it with glue. I can still hang it, but once I put the mechanism, then you'll see this slight bulge happening. So it'll be better if we stick this. So I'll take this off again and put some glue. Now to stick this, I am using a glue gun. Okay, let's place it back in. And now we'll press it down and wait for maybe a minute or so that it sticks. And then we can remove the pressure from this. There you go. Looks flat now. Now it's not bulging out. Look at that. Looks pretty cool. Nice. So I'm happy with this. Now I am going to punch a hole through the cork so that we can fit the mechanism. So I'm using a thumb pin again and making a hole. Now cork sheet is really soft, so it's not very difficult to make a hole. So we have a hole here. Now we'll do the same thing. We will pass the scissor through it and make the hole slightly bigger. Now I'll take a pencil and I'll pass it through. Just like this. And there you go. We have a nice clean hole. Now we'll take the mechanism of the wall clock. All right, so the lock is in place. Looks pretty neat. It's nice and tight. When you're putting this lock, just hold it in place and then you can just rotate the whole mechanism body and it'll tighten. So there you go. Now all you need to do is add the hands. So here I have the hands. So first we'll put the hour hand. Now we'll put the minutes hand. And now I can easily slide in this seconds hand and our wall clock will be complete. But I have a tiny little detail that I'm going to add and this will look even better. So let's take out this seconds hand. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this seconds hand and I'm going to cut this metal piece out from either side and just use this middle portion. And on top of this, I'm going to attach a plastic sheet with a tiny little aircraft. So when it turns, it'll look like a tiny little aircraft is going around the world. Okay, so let's do that. Now to make the plastic hand, I'm using this packaging. Now I'm sure whenever you buy a toy or some device, you get this plastic packaging inside. This packaging is pretty sturdy and we need material like this. So I'm going to just cut a strip out. So here you can see that I've cut a strip out. Actually, you can't see that I've cut a strip out. It almost looks invisible and that's what we need. We want this strip to be our seconds hand so that when we attach an aircraft to this, it will almost look invisible. So it'll look like the aircraft is flying on its own. Okay, so now we'll just make this slightly thinner and I'll score a line right in the middle and we'll just fold it to give it more strength. So So I scored a line in the middle. Scoring means you just apply a little bit of pressure to create a dent, but you don't cut it. And on that scored line, you can easily fold the plastic. There you go. Although it's a lot more visible now, but it has more strength, which is important because it's going to hold a small aircraft. And the aircraft I have cut out of paper, it's a simple silhouette. So now I'm going to stick this on one end and I'm going to cut this metal bit out of the hand and then stick this plastic piece right on top of this. So let's do that. Now let's place the second hand on the wall clock and see how much we need. Okay, so I have a rough idea and I'm going to cut a little bit. There you go. Now I'll apply a little bit of glue and stick the aircraft on it. There you go. Our second hand is ready with this tiny little aircraft flying. All right, let's attach this to the wall clock and boom, it's ready. Look at that. Looks pretty cool. Now let's put the battery in and see whether our aircraft flies or not. And there you go. Our aircraft is flying around the world. Look at that. I'm super happy with this. What do you guys think? I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and found this tutorial easy and helpful. Guys, I'm always up for recycling. I'm always up for DIY. Why? Because of this. Look at this. We took a paint can lid and converted it into world map wall clock. Look at that aircraft flying. I think it looks pretty amazing. What do you guys think? Please let me know in the comment section below. Also, please give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed and liked it. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'll be very happy if you subscribe. And if you have already subscribed, then a big thank you. You guys are amazing. Also, you can watch more stuff that you can try out. Some are easy, some are a little complicated, some are fun, some are exciting. If you are making this, then don't forget to click pictures and share them with me. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, and right here in the YouTube world, making DIY projects for you guys. So that's it for this video. I'll see you in my next one. Till then, remember to do good and be good. Peace.